Alright, I gotta back into this hole right here. Head out. And then back in. I gotta slide the tandems all the way back. Let's do it. Let's make some money. What a mess. I got a new dash cam. Let's turn them on. I thought it wasn't recording. Oh, yeah, okay. I saw the red light. I was like, what the heck? Okay, it doesn't matter. So I gotta slide the tandems back. Heard that? I had to take the tension off the pins. Back. Make sure they're locked in. Yep, good. Now, drive tandems approximately with the hole, then I right, left, and right. Now, a lot of guys will just go right and then left. Then they stop, then they turn the wheels to the right. Well, the problem with that is they lose critical seconds. So let's go to the left now. And before I stop, the last 6 inches or so, I turn to the right. Not all the way, just enough that when I hit the reverse, it already starts sweeping the trailer in that direction. See that? Now, I went too much, but that's okay, I can fix it. Pick it up in the mirror. I'm very close to that guy. Too close. Pull that a little bit. Make sure to grab over a little bit. Some of that effect is because the trailer tandems are all the way back and I misjudged it. Nice and gentle. Woo! A little bit close. I don't like it. I don't like being that close. It's just a little bit too risky. Bright light doesn't help. Now it's out of my... And back in. Nice and gentle. Scare me there, spitter. I'm just gonna pull ahead now and try to see what I can see in that mirror. And lots of headroom. Okay. Yeah. They don't have any lines on the ground, but you just gotta kind of eyeball it. I think I see the door. So I like to go under a slight angle and then at the last moment or last moments cut it square or straight, and then so I go on an angle so I can see the door rubbers, or the rubber dock rubbers, the big giant rubbers that they cushion your blow. Oh, nice. I feel like I'm going downhill. It's like I think it's gonna be alright. And we'll get out and look at it too and make sure. Okay, I'm touching contact. Contact. Remember what we do. I hit the red one. I pull the red valve first only. That's the trailer brakes. Then I'm still in reverse and I gently let on the clutch a little bit to seat, and then I pull the yellow one to seat into the, so the trailer kingpin is at the front of the, excuse me, front of the fifth wheel tight. It makes it easier to pull the release handle, as opposed to pulling the red valve and going forward, then your kingpin on the trailer is up against the jaw, the lock jaws, very tight. Impossible to pull the release. So let's go check it out. I topped off the trailer before I got here with fuel full. Okay. They want us to chalk both wheels. Probably shouldn't do this yet until I check back here. Guess I gotta move it. But I think I like it. See, that's good. See that? That's good. That is good. And you see that yellow, that's what I was aiming for. Edge of the trailer should go on that, even though you don't have, do not have painted lines. There is a painted line. Is there? No, there isn't. Maybe there used to be. I can't see it. But barring that, you just try to make it, you try to make your trailer parallel to the trailer that's next to you and hope that he's right, and he is. See his yellow line, and I'm on my yellow line. So, and plus the trailers are roughly 2.5 feet apart all the way down, parallel, which is fine. That's what you're looking for. All right, I'm gonna say that's all good. I'm gonna drop the trailer and go pick up my other loaded trailer. It's a drop and hook. Very nice. And I remember, turn off your lights before you unplug the pigtail and pop fuses.